सर प्लीज स्टार्ट द क्लास। हेलो सर,
यस आई विल स्टार्ट।
या
आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल?
या या यू आर ऑडिबल।
ओके dilations of vas deferentia in many group of insects. And the vas deferentia will be joined to form a medium duct for that jack wrinkles. Hello ma'am. Hello ma'am. Are you able to hear me ma'am? The host main host. Hello. You can see here. increases in the vas deferentia from the, this follicles are attached to the vas deferentia through vas efferents. This region, this is called vas efferents. Okay. And as I showed you earlier, this is vas deferens, which will attach to the ejaculatum, urine ejaculatum, and this is the medial vesicle, which arises in the junction of this vas deferentia, the medial vesicle, where the sperms will be stored before this transfer to the female vesicle development. And it will be, as usual, you are having the accessory glands. These accessory glands will be present both in the female reproductive system as well as male reproductive system. These accessory glands will be modified with very important section. You can see here, this accessory glands in normal vision, it will be like a cluster. In this is unraveled vision, which means it is opened. They have opened and showed this position of accessory glands. And we will see the function of accessory glands later in the upcoming slide. It is the male reproductive system of the locus gregarium gene. And the genitrio, in this you can see the modification. Here the testes are modified and here it's like a lobe. And the glands, the accessory glands are modified as a V-shaped gland here. And the seminal vesicles usually present here. And finally, you are identifying that is here in the ejaculatum, medial ejaculatum. And you can see the structure inside of this every follicle. I mean, this is a testes. You can see like this, the follicles will be arranged. One follicle, two, three, like this. And it will be enclosed outside with a sheath called peritoneal sheath. It provides protection and everything. And usually these follicles are epithelial cells. The follicle system made up of epithelial. This you can see, this is last difference. These are attached to the last difference. Male accessory glands, usually it may be the accessory glands I have told now. The accessory glands usually may be ectodermal in origin, may be mesodermal in origin. The ectodermal in origin you can tell it as an ectadenia, and the mesodermal origin you can tell as mesadenia. This, in some group of insects, the ectadenia has been seen. This what it is modified means, accessory glands will open directly into duct cavity. It will open into the duct cavity directly. In case of mesadenia, mesodermal origin, it opens into vas deferentia instead of ejaculatum. And this ejaculatory glands are usually functioning in adult insects, not in this pupal or in other stages of insects. The main secretions involved by the accessory glands in male reproductive systems are produce a production of this spermatophore and in providing nourishment and the production to the sperms, which is present in the spermatophore. The spermatophore is nothing but it consists of sperms fully, spermatophore. And also in modifying the female behavior and the physiology for mating purposes. And now we can see the sperm. Okay. The mature sperms are usually a flagellate. It's like a flagella like appearance, and it's if you see length and diameter 300 micrometer long series and less than 1 micrometer in diameter. It have two regions, head region and tail region. I will show you a photo here. You can see this is the head region and this is the tail region. And this head region, usually the cells which are present inside the head region will be coated with a glycoprotein and known as glycocalyx. They can ask this in the exam. The cells of the mature sperms are made up of ash, they can give me as it is made up of glycoproteins. The greater part of this region, mainly, the large part of this region is occupied by means of nucleus. The sperms are also divided based on the nucleus of nucleus, based on presence or absence of nucleus. Nucleated sperms, eupyrene nuclei sperms. And the anucleated sperm is called as apyrene. Apyrene is absent. It can be seen in labrum. And in front of the nucleus, the regions of the nucleus are present. Those are called acrosomes. You can see here. This is this is acrosome. This region is acrosome, and this is called the extra acrosomal layer, which extends out from the head region of sperms. And this acrosome is usually involved. So the main function of this acrosome is it attaches involved with the attachment of sperm to the egg while during fertilization. The sperm will attach towards the egg with the help of this acrosome only, because you can see that there is four of every here. With the sharp edge, it will go on the fitted with the egg. And also, it lyses the egg membrane. It helps to lyse it. And other things, you just need to know what are the outer regions from the sperm cell. The sperm bundles of, usually the sperm will be in bundles. It is of art upfront order that are known as spermatogenesis. These will be new to you. Mostly it won't be present in the extra book or usual books you are studying. It has referred some books like Chapman and then Bunsen Gay, Loudon, these are these. Nowadays the questions are they are in somewhat in depth. So far as I had at these points. You can remember this, the spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis of the bundles of sperms in art upfront order. You can see here, already I told, acrosome in front of nucleus, this is in front of nucleus, co-region. You can see acrosome, this is nucleus region, you can see fully, this is the nucleus region, and this is the tail region. And the spermatogenesis. Genesis, you know, genesis means formation. How this sperm formation takes place? This is called spermatogenesis. Usually at the distal end of the testis follicle, we have seen the follicle now, instead of the testis. The distal end is called germarium. This germarium in which the germ cells will divide to mitotically, first it will divide mitotically to produce this spermatogonia. Cells which divide mitotically to produce spermatocytes. After mitosis, they become spermatocytes, the germ cells. And further, the spermatocyte will be dividing meiotically two times to produce spermatids. This is the next stage of this outlook, how it will happen, I told, how it will tell you the intensity. You can, this is a single testis. In this you can see the region, the first region you can see is germarium, what we have seen earlier. Here we can see apical cells, the young cells. The young cells usually present in this germarium region. From this germarium region, next to region is zone 1, it's called as a zone of growth. Next to zone 2, it is called a zone of maturation and reproduction. Next one is the zone 3, it is called a transformation stage. That mature reproduced sperms will be transformed here. And it will attach us with the vast difference. Okay. Before I explain this process, I will tell you this. Three zones of development are commonly recognized below, next to germinate. Zone of growth, usually in which the primary spermatogonia enclosed with the cyst, which divides and usually increases in the size to form spermatocytes. As I told earlier, now we are seeing in the spermatocytes. You can see here, this germinal region is there, no? And next to the zone of growth in this region, it will form as a cyst and it will further will form the spermatoconia. The germ cells will be changed into spermatocytes. You can see the spermatocytes. This big cells are there, no? Next to spermatocytes, you can, in this region, from this zone growth region, you can, the mitosis will take place. Next to this, you can see the meiosis. In the zone, next to zone, maturation production, in this region, we have meiosis direction division. So only this region is called as maturation production. Here, due to meiosis, these spermatocytes are converted into changes, changes into spermatids. Zone of maturation reproduction, in which each spermatocyte undergoes a two meiotic division to produce these spermatids. And next to this is the zone of transformation, as I showed in the picture, in which the spermatids develop into spermatozoa. It's a process called spermiogenesis. You need to, this is spermiogenesis, the single one process where spermatids are developed into spermatozoa. It is called spermiogenesis. The whole process from the germ cell to complete formation of a single sperm, it is called fully process is called spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is different, spermiogenesis is different. We should not confuse with both. Okay. You can see how we get the photos here. You can see them. I mean, starting from the apical follicular germinal region of neutral end germ cells, which is called as spermatogonia, which grows into mitotically grows into spermatocytes, which are in the region of growth, zone of growth. And in the zone of maturation puberty, during those maturation are called meiosis two times, and it further develops into grows into spermatics, and from spermatics it further it the zone of transformation develops into spermatozoa, and finally it moves out through the vas deferens, and from vas deferens it comes out through the ejaculator, and ejaculator projects out through vulva that I showed here. Usually the spermatics which produce at the meiosis stages will be a rounded cell. It won't appear like any other shape. Usually rounded cell. Some insects it may change. I have told it has to be modified as a sperm, and this part is called spermiogenesis. And the spermatocytes reach meiosis in some insects, not some insects, most insect species. The spermatocytes reach meiosis before the final moon phase. But in case of the insects which do not feed at adult, some insects, for example, if you take termites, in some insects, usually the young stages, the immature stages only will be consuming food or it only will do the reproduction, it only will do most of the functions in the insect body. Those insects reach this stage before adult eclosion itself. It will be before becoming adult eclosion, this stage will be the spermiogenesis stage will be reached by it. Now we will go for immunity system.
Sir, lot of disturbance is there, sir. It's not audible.
It's not audible.
Yes, sir. Voice is very low. Lot of vibration is there, sir. No, sir. Not audible.
Hello.
Yes, sir. It's audible, sir.
Now it's audible, Okay.
Yes, sir.
This male reproductive system again. I will just revise it once because you may just important points. I will revise you because you can't able to hear properly. You know earlier, just some points I will tell. Actually, male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes, which are usually connecting with a pair of seminal vesicles. And it finally it reaches to become a median ejector duct through which the sperms will be sent out. And it consists of an accessory glands, which usually opens into this vas deferens or else ejector duct. and the testes may lie above or else below the abdomen of insects. And usually the testes will consist of follicles. These follicles will be ranging from 1 to 100, differing in some group of insects. Usually it is more than 100 in case of Orthoptera, and in Coleoptera it is usually 1. In case of Diptera, this testes will be formed like an undivided sac. And in some Lepidoptera, this testes used to form a single median structure. And as I told from this picture, you can see earlier I told from the follicles, this follicles in the testes will be attached to vas differentia through a membrane called vas afferens. This vas afferens or the small regions or vas afferens. And the testes which consist of follicles which are inside will be covered outside with a protective sheath called peritoneal sheath. Very important. Last year, this year 2020 in SRF examination, they asked the question. The outer sheath is called outer sheath of this testes is called ash. And it is usually the follicles which present inside are made up of epithelial cells, or called follicular epithelial cells, which provides nutrition for the testes to grow. And it attaches to vas differentia. And this male accessory glands, if you see, the male accessory glands may be of ectodermal origin or else of mesodermal origin. We can call it as ectodenia and mesodenia. This ectodermal origin of this accessory glands will consist of which modified into in the manner this accessory glands will be open into ejector duct directly without connection with vas differentia in ectodermal origin. The growth insects which consist of ectodermal origin. In case of this mesodermal origin, mesodenia, usually this accessory glands will be open into vas differentia instead of ejector duct directly. And the accessory glands in male reproductive system functions in producing spermatophore. It is a packet. The spermatophore is like a packet which consists of sperms present inside it. And it also functions in providing nourishment and production to the sperms. It also modifies the female behavior and physiology, which helps in mating. And usually the mature sperm, which are flagellate, it will have flagella, it can able to swim, it can able to move motile. Flagellate means motile, and its length will be 300 micrometer long, and it's usually less than 1 micron in diameter. It having two regions, one is head region, another one is tail region. This head region, which consists of, the cell of testes, which consists of a coat, outer coat, or else not outer coat. It's having one coating. It's called glycocalyx, which made up of glycoprotein. It's important. They may ask in exam. The greater, usually, the head region consists of two regions. One is, the head is having two portions. One is the major portion, which consists of nucleus. This nucleus may be the sperms may be divided based on the presence or absence of nucleus. Nucleated sperms are called eupyrene nucleus. Eupyrene nucleus. And anucleated sperms are called apyrene. A means absent. Apyrene, which usually present in Lepidopteran group of insects. And the region which present in front of nucleus is called acrosome. Right. This region is called acrosome. This is nucleus region. You can see this in the head region. This is tail region. This is nucleus in the head region. In front of this head region, you can see this acrosome. This acrosome is having some extra layer which present like a needle shape, which be present outer side of the head. It is used for attachment with the egg during a fertilization process. And this acrosomes, the main function of this acrosome is, as I told, it attaches, it helps to attach the sperm to egg, and also it helps to lyse the egg membrane. And the sperm bundles of Orthoptera and Ordinate are called as spermatodesums. You note this point, spermatodesums. It's not that much, there is no need, you need to, for PG level, you need to see this much in depth. But I'm giving, maybe it may be useful for you in future if they ask any questions from this. Mostly I have referred from good books, these all points what you are seeing here. The sperm bundles are nothing but the sperms are compiled in the group of orthoptera and ordinata to form spermatodesums. And the process of this sperm formation, total process from the germ cell to complete sperm formation, spermatozoa production, it is the process called as spermatogenesis. It starts with germarium. This germarium is nothing but it is a distal end of testicular follicles, testis follicle. And it is usually consists of young cells, because from here only the germ cells will divide, they start dividing, which divide to form spermatogonia, again through mitosis. And from spermatogonia, again, cells which divide mitotically to produce spermatocyte. Then spermatocyte again divide meiotically to produce spermatids. Now we can see in-depthly how the process is going on. This is the picture. You can find the region, the germarium region, growth zone 1 is the growth region, zone 2 is the maturation reproductive region, and zone 3 is the transformation region. In this total, this total region forms the a single testis, which is inside which consists of follicular cells, which provides nutrition to the growth of testis. Okay, and first of all, you can see the three zones of development which are commonly recognized below the germarium. I mean, next to germarium. Germarium is the region which consists of young cells, testicles, at germ cells. Next to that, you can see the zone of growth. In this zone of growth, primary spermatogonia usually enclosed in a cyst, which divides mitotically and increase in size to form spermatocytes. And this next to that zone of growth, you can see the zone of maturation reproduction. Sorry, reduction. Reduction itself, you can tell meiosis is the reduction division reaction, in which each spermatocytes will undergo two meiotic division to produce the spermatids. And next to this is the zone of transformation. In this zone of transformation, the spermatids will be developed into spermatozoa. It is the final sperm. This process, the conversion of the spermatid to spermatozoa, is called spermiogenesis. You need to remember spermiogenesis. But the whole process from the germ cell to formation of full spermatozoa or sperm is called a spermatogenesis. You can see the regions here. First one is the germarium. From here, the spermatogonia, which will form like a cyst here, which mitotically divide to form spermatocyte. Again, in the zone of growth, again, the spermatocytes will undergo meiosis division in the zone of maturation reduction, and it forms spermatids. Further, the spermatids will be changed to spermatozoa, the transformation region, which connect to vas differentia. From the vas differentia, this sperms will be sent out to through median ejector duct. And as I told earlier, this the spermatocytes usually reach meiosis before final molt of insect in many group of insects. In some case of some group of insects, it will reach before the final molt itself. Specifically in insects which feed in immature stage itself, before it reaching adult. That's all about male reproductive system. Now we can see about the female reproductive system. Before we are going to female reproductive system, I will mention you one thing. Both male and female reproductive system are nearly same. Both are nearly having same parts. The names will be changed. That's all. Just first of all, I'll tell the outlook of the female reproductive system. Female reproductive system usually consists of a pair of ovaries, which connect with the, instead of testes, here you can get the ovaries, pair of ovaries. There will be a testes will be there. Here ovaries, which connect with a pair of lateral oviducts. There vas differentia you can see, two lateral ducts called vas differentia. Here instead of that, you can see lateral oviducts. These join to form a median oviduct opening posteriorly in the genital chamber. There you can see the ejectory duct, common ejectory duct. Instead of that, here you are seeing the median oviduct, which open in the posterior region of abdomen, the last posterior region of abdomen into genital chamber, which usually opens. Sometimes this genital chamber forms a tube. It forms some tube called vagina. And this often developed to form bursa copulatrix. Nothing but this bursa copulatrix is the region where insects, I mean the male insect will mate, and opening from the genital chamber or the vagina is the spermatheca. And this, in the genital chamber, you can see one opening. It's called spermatheca. It is used for storing the sperms after the mating with a male. And as usual, I told here also a pair of accessory glands will be present. Now we can see in depthly. The two ovules, it's like two testes there. The ovules, which usually lies in the abdomen, above the abdomen, or else to the lateral side of the gut. Gut region will be there, no? It's a lateral side of the gut region, the posterior area. And each consists of ovules. Each ovule ovary consists of ovules. Ovules are nothing but it's like branches of ovaries, which comparable with the follicles in the testes. Testes, and you can see the follicles, you know, like this, it will be there. This each ovule, actually every single ovule has a sheath which made up of two layers. An outer layer is called tunica externa, and the inner layer is called tunica properia. This usually the tunica properia surrounds the whole ovule and the terminal filament. There you can see germarium. Instead of germarium, here you can see the terminal filament. Is it present in the terminal region? I will show the photo right now. You can see here this region. This is called terminal filament. This fully is called ovary. This this single like follicles, it is called ovaries. This complete ovaries combined to form the ovary. Two ovaries are there. Instead of the male reproductive system, you can see the vast difference here. Instead of that, you can tell here it's a lateral oviduct. This ovaries attached to vas deferentia by callus. There, vas efferentia. Vas efferentia helps to connect the testicular follicles with vas deferentia. Instead of that, here calyx attaches the same with the lateral oviduct, which joins commonly to form common oviduct. There it is ejectory duct, and which forms the genital chamber. This genital chamber opens out through vagina and through vulva. This vagina is a tube-like structure. This is appears like a tube, no? It's further become developed in many group of insects to form bursa copulatrix, where which helps in mating. And this genital chamber opens into spermatheca. You can see the spermatheca. The spermatheca consists of spermatheca gland. Actually, the function of the spermatheca gland is it produces some fluids which keeps the spermatheca alive. I mean, in the viable condition. And as usual, you can see the accessory gland which opens in the genital chamber. This is the structure of female reproductive system from filament to vagina. As I told earlier, each ovule, which consists of the long terminal filament, in the photo we can see, and proximally, the proximal region, the ovary narrows to a fine duct, that is the pedicel. In this photo, it doesn't show the pedicel. This ovary is there, no? This ovary will be narrowed to form a pedicel here. This pedicel region is not mentioned here. And usually, I told the two lateral oviducts join to form a median oviduct. The median oviduct opens at the gonophore. The gonophore is nothing but that genital chamber you have seen, no? That is seen in insect abdomen as gonophore. That's all. The gonophore of common oviduct usually is concealed in an inflection. Inflection means it's present as like a layers. Inflection of the body wall that typically forms a cavity called a genital chamber. This is the genital chamber. You have seen, no? The genital chamber. And this chamber serves as a copulatory pouch during mating. And that's often known as bursa copulatrix. I already told it. What is the use of this bursa copulatrix, how it forms. And it's an external opening. This bursa copulatrix is opened outside. From the outside of insect, you can see like a slit. Slit means a small opening, which is called vulva. In many insects, this vulva is narrow. And in the genital chamber becomes like an enclosed tube, referred to as vagina. You already seen. in the Lepidoptera, if you see in Lepidoptera, Lepidoptera are divided by means of this reproductive openings only. Monotrichia, Diatrichian Lepidoptera, they will tell. This monotrichian Diatrichian Lepidoptera is nothing but in the females of this Diatrichian Lepidoptera, will have two reproductive openings. But in the monotrichia, it will have only one reproductive opening. The one in this Diatrichian Lepidoptera, one opening will be present in the ninth abdominal segment, which helps in discharging of egg outside the, to outside environment, the egg will be discharged by from the ninth segment. And it is known as oviporous, pore, open, ovi, egg, egg producing open, is called oviporous. The other, on the another one is will be present in the eighth segment, which is nothing but the copulatory opening. It is called vulva. We already saw vulva. We already seen that vulva leads to bursa copulatrix, and usually it's connected with the sperm duct. We already saw the diagram. I told earlier, spermatica used for the storage of sperm and the female accessory gland. Now we can see the female accessory gland. This is very important. This female accessory glands having different types of function in different group of insects. I have mentioned some specific and important functions here. Actually, this female accessory glands arise from the genital chamber or vagina in different insects, different group of insects. It's maybe in vagina in some insects, or else in the upper surface of the genital chamber in some insects. Usually, these genital glands produce a substance for attaching the eggs to the substratum where the insect will lay its eggs during oviposition. This is called, it is also called as collateral glands or glue glands. It will produce gum-like substance, which helps to attach to their substrates. So it is called collateral or glue glands. And I will tell later the functions of accessory gland back while we are going back. And in case of oogenesis, as we have there, we saw is spermatogenesis, which is the formation of the process of formation of sperms from germ cell is called spermatogenesis. Here in the oogenesis, same how this egg oocytes formed. This production, this procedure is called oogenesis. Each ovary will consist of distal germarium, terminal segment. Next one is germarium here. In this each ovule, in which the oocytes are produced from oogonia. They are spermatogonia, spermatocyte, spermatid, spermatozoa. Here you are seeing oogonia, oocytes, and then you can the deposition of vitel. I will tell the, first of all, I will tell the structure. Each ovule consists of a distal germarium in which oocytes are produced from oogonia, and a more proximal vitellarium in which a yolk is deposited in the oocyte. Nothing but, I will show the photo. Actually, this single ovule, which consists of a terminal, this is ovary fully. You imagine by taking the single ovule. In the single ovule, next to this terminal filament, you can see the germarium region. In this next to germarium region, you can see the vitellarium region. This vitellarium region is nothing but the oocyte, which coming from the germarium region, will be deposited with the yolk. Usually, egg will consist of yolk. No, that yolk will be deposited in this vitellarium region. So only here I have mentioned distal region is germaria. The proximal means opposite, and the down region is called vitellarium, in which yolk is deposited in the oocyte. And actually, the oocyte pass back to the ovule and it enlarges. And as it leaves the germarium, it is clothed by some tissues called as follicular tissues. The same where in the testes we see follicular epithelium, the same will be present here. It is also the same, it does the same function. Hello. Now, you can see, I doesn't want to tell in-depthly about this. There is no need for you. Just I will tell the functions of that follicular cells and the types of follicular cells and how it is attaches with how it helps in deposition of this vitellarium, the proteins for egg formation and egg production. The actually the function of follicular cells, if you stay, it helps in production of vitellin envelope. The vitellin envelope, which it's an important part in the egg, which is produced by the follicular cells, and it also produces the egg cell called as a chorion. And it helps in production of the proteins, which helps to form the main functions in formation of this vitellin and other proteins, yolk proteins, that I will show you here. There are two broad categories of ovules. One is panoistic type of ovule, another one is meristic type of ovule. This panoistic type of ovule is nothing but it won't have any special nursing cells. Nurse cells are nothing but these are nutrient providing cells. The this ovules are there, no? It should be given with some nutrients for their development. For this, there is a special group of cells called nurse cells will be present. In the group of insects like Thysanurans, Odonata, Plecoptera, and Isoptera and Siphonoptera, this panoistic type of ovule will be present, where the nurse cells or the special cells won't be present. It will be absent. This nurse cells is also called as tropocytes. And in the consist of, in case of this meristic type of ovules, you can see nurse cells called or tropocytes, which helps in providing nutrients for the growth of the eggs in the ovule. There are two types of meristic ovule usually. One is telotrophic, another one is polytrophic. These two types are based on the presence of tropocytes. I mean, this nerve cells is there, no? Where this nerve cells are present, based on that region of presence, it's of two types, telotrophic and polytrophic. In this telotrophic ovule, the tropocytes usually present in the germanium region itself. It won't come down from the germanium to vitellarium region. It will be present in the germanium region. And it is also called as acrotropic. Acro itself means it is in the terminal region, terminal or acro. Are the same meaning. Its example is Hemiptera and Polyphaga of Coleoptera. Polyphaga is one of the suborder of Coleoptera. You refer after the class what are the orders which comes under Polyphaga. And polytrophic. Polytrophic is nothing but the usually the nurse cells, tropocytes are there, no? It usually present close to the oocytes. It's seen in most group of insects, Dermoptera, Socoptera, Theropoptera, and all holomotobolous group of insects. You can see this, except in Coleoptera and Siphonoptera. These are no need. Actually, now another one important thing I will tell here. This you can, before that, you can see here. This is ovule. You can see this is a ovule. In this ovule, you can see here oocyte. This oocyte is supported with nutrients. I mean, for its growth, the nutrients are provided by tropocytes or nurse cells. These are the tropocytes or nurse cells. Okay, it is simply a telotrophic ovule. The telotrophic ovule, I told now that tropocytes will be present in the terminal region. Terminal in this region, only tropocytes will be present. Here, oocytes are there. It is connected with the nutritive cord. This nutritive cord is nothing but it will supply this nutrients which produced by tropocytes to oocytes. In case of this polytrophic ovule, you can see here it is it's a ovule sheath. You can see here it is an this. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. In the telotrophic ovule, usually the oocytes become clothed by follicle cells after they are leaving the germarium. But each oocyte will be connected with the germarium by a nutritive cord I showed in the photo that extends to the trophic tissue. And in the polytrophic ovule, the tropocytes move down completely. Here, the tropocytes won't move in the telotrophic ovule. Just it will be connected to the oocytes with the help of a nutritive cord. But in case of polytrophic ovule, the tropocytes fully, it will move down the ovule and it will be enclosed in the follicle. You can see in this diagram. See, this is a troposite. Okay, this is a oocyte. This troposite completely will be come and it will be enclosed inside this oocyte. This is, you can see the next stage here. Here it is troposite. It is enclosed completely with the follicular epithelium. This is only thing. This the content. The content of yolk, as I mean oocyte. The oocyte usually consists of 10% of euplasm. Euplasm is nothing but the cytoplasm along with the nucleus. It is called euplasm. Remaining that 90% is with yolk only, fully. Okay. In this 90%, nearly 60 to 90% this yolk protein is in the form of vitellogenins. This vitellogenins. The vitellogenins are nothing but these are mostly produced in all group of insects. It helps in the manufacturing of it is manufactured outside the oocyte. It will enter the oocyte and often undergoes some modification to form vitellins. Simply, these vitellogenins are the or the agents or any the substance which are produced during vitellogenesis to form yolk protein. Okay, the process of yolk accumulation in insects oocyte is called vitellogenesis. I told earlier in the germarium region the oocytes will be the oocytes from germarium region will be sent to the vitellarium region. In that vitellarium region you can see this vitellogenesis process in which the yolk will be deposited inside the oocyte. Actually, I sorry for telling the structure of this ovule. The ovule structure usually consists of terminal filament, germarium, vitellarium. These three are the main zones. Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 in testes, like this. And this vitellogenin, I have told now, this vitellogenin protein. Here you can see the vitellogenins. This vitellogenins usually synthesized by means of with the help of juvenile hormone, which is present in the fat body. Okay, now we can see the type of reproduction in insects. Mostly you will know this, but I added some new examples along with this and new terminologies may be useful in further exams. You can see, first of all, the insect reproduction is of two types. One is oviparity, another is viviparity. Oviparity, mostly insects will lay the eggs, reproduction by means of laying eggs. In the viviparity, the initiation of egg development takes place within the mother itself. Before the egg comes out itself, the egg will be laid in the mother's reproductive system. And even after developing, also the young will be, the young offspring will be retained within the mother. It is the oviparities of three, four or five types. Here I mentioned the important types. Ovoviviparity. Ovoviviparity is nothing but fertilizer eggs incubated inside the female. And it will be developed, and the fully developed egg hatch immediately after laid or going to be laid from the reproductive tract. It's usually seen in some species of cockroaches, aphids, scales, and in some flies also. Calliphoridae is very important. This Calliphoridae group of insects usually reproduce by means of this oviparity only. And pseudoplacental viviparity. Pseudoplacental viviparity is nothing but in some group of insects during development, there will be deficient of yolk in the egg. So the mother provides some special placenta-like tissue in its reproductive system. From that, the nutrients will be transferred to the embryo. It's usually seen in aphids and earwigs. And hemocoelous viviparity. Hemocoelous viviparity is usually seen in the insects like bedbug, which acts as a parasite. And Strepsiptera, stylopits, and in some gall midges. It usually involves the growth of an embryo developing freely in the female hemolymph without any egg formation or placental formation. Just it will nourish the hemolymph of this its mother, and it will develop. And that larva will be exist in brood canals. That brood canals is nothing but it consists of a blood hemolymph present inside it. And usually the gall midges, where their larva may consume the mother itself. Mother means nothing but the inside the mother system, reproductive system, it will consume its blood, everything. Next one is adenotropic viparity. Adenotropic viparity is usually some insects, they're during hatching, it's developed very poorly. Its development will be, it can't able to feed orally. So in that case, there will be a special gland called accessory glands. You are already, we have seen, though it is also called as milk gland, which secretes some fluids for this growth of young ones in the uterus of mother's reproductive system. And the fully grown larva, it will be deposited and it will pupate immediately after the deposition itself. While it's going to be laid, that immature stage laid from the female reproductive system, immediately after laying, within few hours, it will go to pupal stage. It's seen specifically in the tsetse fly, warble flies, and kits. And some terminologies we can see, sexual reproduction insects usually called as ampimixes. And if the insects present, male and female present, reproductive system present in the male and female separately, it's called a gonochorism. And if the male and the females are diploid in nature, it is called a diploploidy. In case the male and reproductive system present in the same individual, then it is called hermaphroditism. You can see this in scales, Eicheria purchase, you can see this hermaphroditism. It will show both characters, male character as well as female character. And development of eggs without fertilization is called parthenogenesis. This parthenogenesis is of three types: thylotoki, arachentoki, ampitoki. Presence of in which sex it is present, based on that it is divided. Just I will tell, in usually thylum, in Telugu I don't know whether they will tell thylum or not. In Tamil we will tell thylum only. For females, just for remembering, I'm telling, it's like a funny thing. For if you females, mostly females, they are getting a headache, they used to put this thyla, so you remember like that, females thylotoki. In case of males, men's will be arrogant, more arrogant. So they like Tamil, we will tell arakan. For a monster or else of asuran, we will tell arakan in Tamil. So it's like arakan toki. You can remember like arakan, arakan toki. Arakan means male and thylum, thylotoki for female. If both sexes are present, it is called ampito. Both sexes are produced, reproduced. It is through pathogenesis, it is called ampitoki. If only females are produced, it is thylotoki. Males are produced, it is arachentoki. Both the sexes are produced, then it is called ampi or deutotoki. That's all. And in some insects, they will bypass their life cycle. Suddenly they will be in larval stage, first instar. Suddenly they will go for pupa, or else without pupal stage, they will go to adult stage. It is by means of precocious development. It is called pedogenesis. It is also of two types, larval pedogenesis and pupal pedogenesis. Reproduction by larval insect. I mean, the insect larval stage itself reproduce. It is seen in gall midges. And pupal pedogenesis. The embryos are directly formed in the hemocele of mother. Mother's pupa. Mother's pupal hemocele itself. Hemocele is not, I told earlier, while I'm taking circulatory system. Hemocele is the place where this... hemolymph will be present. That's all. And the polyembryony, you may know, in the parasitic insects, from it involves reproduction by means of two or more embryos from one egg. Just from one egg, they will divide subdivision. With the subdivision, two or more embryos will be produced in parasitic insects. Example, braconids. The braconid wasps will be produced by this manner. And neoteny, it's a new terminology. Maybe first time many people will come to know. You just note it. It is a non-terminal instar. Non-terminal instar means nothing but, if for example, one Lepidopteran larva is there, it is having five instars of larval stage. This third instar is, for example, I'm telling, third instar is a non-terminal instar, which develops reproductive features of adult. What are the adult having? Adult like ability to locate a mate, it's or copulation, or else of deposition of egg. All these things will be, all these characters will be shown by a non-terminal instar also, like third instar or second instar. Usually it is seen in the scales, cocidae. That's all. It's I have made more points. I mean, I referred more and prepared this, so it's take too much of time. And sorry for the initial inconvenience. If any doubts you are having, you can ask. Hello. Anyone, if you are having doubts, please ask me.
Sir, in male reproductive system, zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 developments. Can you review, sir?
Okay, wait. I will just wait a minute. See, actually, this is a terminal region of male this testis. This is a testy. This is a terminal region. Usually, in the terminal region, the germ cells will be present here. This germ cells are nothing but these are the young cells, young sperm cells. From this only, the sperm, the one complete sperm will be developed. These cells will be present in this apical region, germinium. From here, this we can tell that this is a spermatogonia. This young germ cells are called spermatogonia. From this, the spermatogonia will be undergoes mitotic division, mitosis process in the region called growth zone 1, growth region. From this after 2 germarium until the zone 2 maturation and reproduction, we can call it as a zone of growth. It is the first zone or else zone of growth. Here, the spermatogonia will be divided by means of mitosis to form spermatocyte. Okay, this is the spermatocyte. From the spermatocytes, it will undergo meiosis. Meiosis is nothing but the reduction and division. Two times meiosis will happen. It is called zone 2. It is called zone of maturation and reduction. Here, the spermatocyte is further transferred to, developed into spermatid. The spermatid you can see here. Next one is the zone of transformation. Here nothing but the spermatid will be transformed to spermatozoa. Okay, the spermatozoa is the final sperm. Then the spermatozoa will be transferred through vas deferentia towards the ejectory duct. That's all. Are you able to understand?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You can this material do one thing. Maybe last time itself I have told the circulatory system as well as another one system. Two systems, respiratory system. I forgot to send the PPTs. I will send this PPT, both three. Anybody, please try to contact your in-charge person to get it from me. Maybe I will forget. So only I'm telling. Now I have taught you this. Once you read this PPT fully with the photos I have given here, you will understand full. Nothing they can ask above apart from this. This is very, very high in the UG to PG standard. Even PhD students usually won't take this much. Okay. Any other doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. You are having any other class after this? 12 o'clock, ma'am told that Lakshmi ma'am told another one class we will be having.
No, sir, nothing is informed in our group.
Okay, only four, three students only today came. Only 3 persons are there, or some other persons today not present to the class?
Not present, sir. You are informing at 5 minutes before the class right now, sir. So we are unable to join at the time.
Only I asked, even if it is time takes also, I will wait like this. They told that after this, you may be having some other classes like this, they told. So only. Okay, no issues. If you are, at any time, if you are getting doubt also, contact me. Now I'm doing PG entomology in Madhya Pradesh, final year.
Okay.
Now you people are final years or third years?
Finally, yes, sir.
Okay, where which college?
SBVR Agriculture College, Badvel, sir. Kadapa okay. district.
Okay, okay, okay. Mm. Okay. Okay, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
If you're getting doubts, call me or contact me through your seniors. Okay, yeah. Mm. Bye. Thank you. Thank you for everyone.
Number still I remember trimester 2016 any idea students about reconnaissance survey detailed reconnaissance survey XYZ we have learned many things now no idea we didn't learn about survey Okay, anyhow, I think no one is don't know about the survey. What is a survey? Anyhow, we will see that. We will see what type of surveying are there, what is the type of surveys, and how the mapping usually done in soil. Soil survey. Change the training. One, two, three students are there. Okay, very good. I'll share the PPT now. Okay, is it visible? Is my screen is visible to everyone?
Awesome.
Let's start the form our formal lecture. Okay, before going to start, now naturally we have all our two MSc students also there. Anyhow, students, now let interact with each other. So very first, what is soil? So each mapping unit, we will encounter with some technical words called. Okay. Is it audible, students, now? Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello? Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Oh, finally. Thank you very much. Right, students, soil delineation. We will go for a soil mapping after doing all the survey, after knowing all the things, you know, after knowing all the characteristics, all the ground truths, after digging profiles, taking auger sample.